Next up on the workshop, a kit I was excited about since I heard about the whole garage accessory series. Number three, the Get On Up two-post hydraulic lift. Check that thing out. It is awesome, and we're going to get a chance to build it up here. This is the third in the 125th scale shop accessory series from AMT. So let's see what's all going to be in the box. First up will be this awesome sheet of decals. Just like the other two kits, which I've done full reviews on that I will link below, you can see that this has a ton of useful decals. Check out the motivational poster with the box art from one of the other kits. We got the typical shop rate one. We got some warnings. We got enter and stop signs for the lift. This is all spectacular. Beautiful set of decals on that kit that can be used on this kit and even more. We've also got, and this is very important, a real piece of flexible vinyl hose. And it's not stiff, it's real rubber. It feels flexible, like spaghetti. That's so that we can do our air wrench part of the diorama and run that off to a compressor. So they do include that, and it's not super stiff, so you can actually use it. We've got part of our lifting arms here, and the kit is adjustable. You can move it up and down as you wish, and these teeth will interlock into the posts. So you can see that, some beautiful parts there. We don't have a lot of plastic in this kit. It's going to be a very easy build. That's the center bottom of the lift, the part that your car goes clunk, clunk over when you drive over. We've got our motor system there. We've got our bottom of our figure. We've got our lifting arms, and I'm going to turn those around in a second. We've got the arm of our figure. We've got more parts of the lifting arms on this tree. And we'll flip that around. You can see your adjustment points on your lifting arms look great. All the detail is very crisp, and it's a new mold, so there is no flash whatsoever. Check this out. You wanted a shop diorama, you got one. You got a huge concrete slab. You don't have to make your own base for the lift. It's going to sit like that. Let's count that out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 inches long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 inches wide. It's got a molded open floor drain. It's got concrete texture. It's got concrete seams and the mounting plates for your lift. So I'm going to get these parts degreased with some Simple Green, and we'll be back for a quick sub-assembly show off. Assembly up to this point is insanely simple. What we're doing is we're putting the lifting arms on. Those will adjust on the side of the lifting posts. What you'll do is you've got those patterns in there. You'll just press each one as you want to change the level, and it'll stay right there. You can move it up and down and wherever you want whenever you build your model. So it doesn't take long to get to this point, maybe 30 minutes to build both the lifting arms and the figure. You can see on the lifting arms, they swing out freely back and forth. Do not glue those pins. And then on the bottom, you've got your adjustment to slide it in and out for the different size vehicles. So you can push them in, you can push them out. Now, I'm gonna pull them all the way out so when I get some paint on this, I can get full paint coverage and then it'll slide in and out. On the air gun, what I did was to make a more positive mounting location for the flexible rubber hose, I took a small drill bit, you can see it right there, just a hand drill bit, and I drilled right into the handle and then secured two small pieces of braided wire. So now I will, when I get done painting, I will cut that off at about 1/4 inch, slide the rubber hose on there with some super glue, and that will hold forever, and I won't have to worry about that breaking off or snipping off a little plastic nub or anything like that. That'll work more permanently. If you're going to ask, these drill bits are readily available online or at Harbor Freight. They are circuit board drill bits. That's what you're looking for. We've got Mr. Man done. We've got him in his position so he can hold that air gun and work, and he looks great. We just had to put the head and arms on him, do a little cleaning up. We've got the hydraulic motor and its reservoir all assembled, so there's not a lot of assembly needed. What I'm going to be doing now is heading over to the paint area, picking out my paint colors, and shooting some color. And as always, I'd like you to come along with me. Thank you. Out of paint, this will end up being a nice quick build. And sometimes you need these. They're slump breakers. You still got to do some painting and decaling, but it's really not difficult. There's no real things to worry about. Now, being held in my jeweler's vise, these are available anywhere on eBay. I've got him in his denim blue jumpsuit, got his first coat of paint on there. I am just using a craft paint, literally called Blue Jean. We know it's a jumpsuit because it's got buttons all the way down to the crotch there, and also it shows as a jumpsuit on the box. So we've got everything else painted. Like I told you, putting that black on those yellow arms really gave us some sweet shadows. A little bit of used look there. I'll be doing very light chip effects on this with some dry brushing of silver paint when we're all done. We've got the base painted, that nice brilliant blue. Same with the posts on the lift. Those are ready to go as is. We've got that pump housing. The electric motor will stay the silver. I will paint the tank a white color for the hydraulics. And then we've got our air gun painted. All I have to do is paint the socket a pavement color. The wires will fit into the hose, and those will be held with a drop of super glue. And then I will just give it a drop of black wash to bring on any little detail, and then glue it in Mr. Man's hand, and we'll be all done. So when we come back, the lift itself will be assembled with no decals on it. We'll have the pump painted, and we'll have Mr. Man painted, and we'll be ready for some decals. And I'll see you in just a second. All right, the lift as it is, right out of the box, is in front of you. Now, I haven't pushed it all the way down. I just gently shoved it on one of the posts to hold it in place while I show you the parts. What I'm going to have to do now is add all the decals and do some weathering and some light chipping effects to get the way that I want it to look. But Mr. Man is all done here. And what I did was dry brushed his uniform a little bit and then gave his face and his hair and his hands a dark wash. I will be gluing the impact wrench into his hands. He stands on his own if you have him on a level surface. I will be gluing the impact wrench into his hands and letting the hose run off the scene to a larger shop compressor. And he is all set to go. I just have to put his name tag on and his back decal on for the shop. The base, of course, the multicolored with the concrete that I painted, that needs to be a little weathered up. I want to go back to my other decals in the other reviews and put some of those cool oil stain decals on here as well. I want to add some vehicle tracks on the concrete. I want to add some light chipping on this lower bar and some light chipping on the lift arms. And then we have to apply all the other decals around the base, the enter, the stop, all the different keep clear emblems and all that stuff. So when I come back, this will be all ready to go. You can see that sweet impact wrench I've glued on there with the wire. That'll go into his hand, and we won't ever have to worry about that breaking off or that hose coming off that cool little impact wrench ever again. So, and I'm so glad that they include flexible cable. Please do so in your other vehicle builds. To round two, I would love to see this more flexible hose being used on the for like spark plugs and hydraulic wires and all that. It's so much nicer than the stiff vinyl cable. It's really, really nice to have. I want to do some dripping around the floor drain, see what other kind of things I can do on this. So you've seen it all built up now. If you wanted to leave it as it is and just throw some decals on it, this is where you'd be at this point. You just put your decals where you want them and you're all set. But we're going to take it just a little bit farther, make it look a little used when I come back for the final. Look how absolutely awesome this is. A callback to the 34 Ford build. You can see that full review. I've got it up on the rack. Russ, with his name tag, is working on it. I love that the hose is nice and long. We can run that off screen, so it looks like it's attached to the shop compressor. It absolutely goes together easily. I did some very easy weathering on it. I used the oil drip decals from other garage accessory kits available by AMT that I've done reviews on. I applied the decals, then I used a scalpel to scrape them and beat them up, and then I just did a bunch of dry brushing with some metallics on the crossbar here to chip those up. And then I use just regular grays, blacks, very bright greens mixed with water for some antifreeze drips. We got the other oil drips from the kits. It just looks absolutely lovely. We've got the tire marks front and back. We'll see some better pictures at the end of the video. I even took some rust effects and rubbed it around the floor drain where the antifreeze and the oil is running illegally. This is an old school shop. It's an easy kit to put together. You can do this entire kit in a few hours. Throw some paint on the figure, throw paint on the rack, and get the decals on. This is a 2-day build at the most. It's a real relaxing rainy day build, comes out beautifully, and it's well designed. Everything goes together just fine. We will take the 34 Ford off. The lift arms are completely adjustable all the way top to bottom. They also open up and close, and they extend and go back in, as I showed you guys during the build. So you can slide these in and out. You can open them wider for bigger vehicles. You can push them in, pull them out, whatever you need to do, and adjust your height depending on what Russ is doing on it that day. Whether he's all the way underneath dropping the transmission or changing oil, or he's working on something like the wheels and tires, whatever you want. This is going to be a beautiful display. I'll be bringing this back for some other reviews, of course, to show off some cars. Everything looks cool on this rack. I don't know what they have coming out next, but hopefully it'll be something cool. Also, remember, if you build it like I did, when you're done, you still have a bunch of cool decals left, as is all the other garage accessory kits. I highly recommend it. There'll be links in the description on where you can pick up your copies right now. These are out on the market, and we will see you at the next review.